Hey folks, I'm back. Live streaming here today, talking about the solar eclipse. I'm just going to organize all my stuff while we wait for people to join. Do, 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 do. Leo, Leo. Leo in the house. Leave a message, post in the comments below. All right, here we are. We're almost there. Where are we? Hi, everybody. Welcome back. Thank you for stopping by. Elaine Marolakos Edelson here. And I am so happy to help you get your mojo back with astrologymojo.com. In the next 40 minutes or so, I'm going to be talking about the Leo eclipse that happens on August 11th at 18 degrees of Leo. And I'm going to cover what that means for just about everyone. And coupled with the July 12th solar eclipse in Cancer, we're still feeling that energy, coupled with the July 27th lunar eclipse, 4 degrees Aquarius. We're still feeling that energy. Is anybody sleeping out there? We're not sleeping. We're not sleeping in this house. Even the dog is not sleeping. Everybody's up at different hours doing different things, trying to get some sleep. And it does affect us, but we're keeping our cool. Okay, some housekeeping before we start, and that is to listen to this event. If you are here live with me now, to make sure that you click the speaker icon below the video, and you can also turn up the volume so that you can hear me. Excellent. Excellente. Also, if you have a question, post it in the comment section and I'll read you later on in about 15 minutes or so. And to also book a reading with me, please click the Book Now button at the top of the page, the little blue button. And let's see, I'm only going to be taking live questions on the live broadcast, not during the replay. So let me know who's showing up, and you can give me your birthday by month and by date, as in May 10th, August 15th. I don't need the year. Okay. I'm just gathering my notes because there's a lot I want to cover today. And with so many retrograde planets on Monday, by the way, Monday the 6th, I'm going to be talking about Uranus in Taurus moving into retrograde for 5 months. 5 months. That's a long time. So I'm going to talk about that on Monday. And I'll give you the info on that later on. Okay. You know, I've read so many folks in the past couple of weeks. I'm so grateful. Thank you to everyone for putting your trust in me and for booking a reading. And it's been, and I'm booking up fast. It's been a whirlwind. And it's been so many people who are truly transforming and wanting to transform on so many levels. So I've been having a lot of fun. Oh, and you know, in the previous live stream, I talked about when I was talking about the Mercury in retrograde, I talked about sightings, and my sister and I call them sightings. People from your past come back, and this is a Mercury in retrograde in the sign of Leo. And I remember saying to you, look back about 19 years or so, the culmination of things that you were doing then is now coming back, or people you knew then are now coming back. So I got notified by an old friend of ours who was actually on Facebook for something, and he saw me on this one of the live streamings, and he called me up and we chatted, and he's also a Leo. So, and it was about 19 years ago that I saw him last. So it's pretty cool how this stuff works out. Okay, so the solar eclipse in Leo is what we're talking about today. It happens at 18 degrees, and It's on August 11th, but we're already feeling this energy, just like we're already feeling the Cancer solar eclipse and the Aquarius lunar eclipse. Please listen to those lives that I did, those streamings that I did. You like my little Bitmoji down in the corner there? That's me sitting on the planet Saturn, because I am a Capricorn rising sign. So this solar eclipse in Leo on August 11th is at 18 degrees. For me, it's right on top of my Uranus. Ah, hey! Well, we'll see what happens there. And the energy is already in effect, and it lasts all the way through September. And depending on where Leo is in your chart, it can trigger many things. And also, if you have planets in the sign of Leo in your chart, take a look at that, because that will tell you the topics that you can expect. Let me show you a diagram of the actual eclipse. I have it all set up here for you. Look at that. So when a solar eclipse happens, the sun and the earth are in line, and the moon line up so that the moon casts a shadow. And this is a partial eclipse, by the way. It's not a total for us, but we're still going to feel the energy. It's still that powerful. Okay. Okay, now, just to cover, in case you haven't listened to my past live streams about the eclipses, eclipses happen in tandem every 2 weeks, every 6 months. So 2 weeks apart, every 6 months, we'll have a lunar and a solar, or a solar and a lunar. This particular time frame, July and August, we're having three eclipses, and that's a lot. It's like eclipse rush hour. There's a lot happening all at once. And with the retrograde planets, it's helping you to go in to discover, is this really what I want? Why do I feel this way? What can I do about it? So we're going to talk about all these things. So let me know if you have any questions. And remember to give me your birth date by month and day, as in January 12th or February 20th. I don't need the year. And your question, of course, to couple along with it. Now, in general, in metaphysics, eclipses bring up the experiences that you have been creating consciously and unconsciously. And the solar eclipse is more masculine in energy, and the lunar eclipse is more feminine in energy. And so, you know, you'll see a culmination of things that you've been working on, and you start to move forward. And in an eclipse phase, timing can seem really off. Time seems strange. It's a concept that we get messed with. I mean, time in the universe, it only exists on this planet anyway. There's no such thing as time. Now is all there is, truly, honestly. But we measure our accomplishments and our agenda by the clock. So it gives us a pattern to follow. It gives us a structure so that we can enact our daily business. Now, when a solar eclipse rolls around, which it does every 6 months, it depends on the sign that it's in. And for this one in Leo, it's going to be a little bit more dynamic because it's a fire sign. So, and that does include weather. Eclipses include weather, so it can mean more heat in certain areas of the planet. It can mean more fires. It can mean more traumatic events, geologically speaking. But for you, it can be a really positive thing. Now, the culmination of your stuff, if you're not paying attention, this is when you might be surprised by what shows up. And we don't always think that things are related. You know, and again, it depends on the degree of the eclipse and where it's happening in your personal chart. And if you have a chart and you know where, let me show you what the Leo, this is what Leo looks like, kind of like a lion with a mane and a tail. And hey, Anne's in the house. Hi, Anne. And so when you know where Leo is in your chart, you can look to see what topics might be coming up if you're familiar with astrology. But definitely it deals with your past endeavors, the culmination of, and also a masculine figure. Now, sometimes, you know, it's not an actual man who walks in your front door. It can be you read a book and you're motivated by it. You see someone give a TED talk and you may not know that they're a Leo or a Leo rising or Leo moon, but they are affecting you in a particular way that motivates you. Or you might get some mail and about a candidate that you might be thinking of voting for. And so, you know, so a masculine energy will come into the picture. Now, I get a lot of questions, and pardon me, it's so dry out here, I have to take drinks often in here in Arizona. I get a lot of questions. Do eclipses make you sick? No, they don't. Although I am sick of not sleeping lately because of all these eclipses. But the eclipse does not make you sick. The solar eclipse merely sheds light on what's happening in your life and what you are creating. And if you have an illness that's brewing in your cells or a malady that has gone unchecked in your body, the eclipses merely shed light on what that is so that you can get the proper attention and you can take care of things. And please let me know. Oh, hi, Lorraine. Lorraine's in the house as well. Please let me know if you know your chart and if you have Leo in your chart, where it might be, and I'm happy to help you out with that. Also, if you have a question, if you're just joining us and you have a question, you can post it in the comments section below. Remember to please give me your birth month and birth day, as in April 12th, but I don't need the year. If you just give me your birthday without a question, I need more specificity. So I need to know what you are looking for. I'm here to help you get your mojo back. So let's do that. And you know, all metaphysical studies and practices, meditation, numerology, astrology, clairvoyance, empathy, all the methods that exist in this world are simply the methods that help you to wake up so that you can discover your consciousness. That's what this whole gig is about here on Earth. What do you want to be doing? How do you want to be doing it? And what do you think is appropriate for you? And hi, Vicky is here. Oh, and Anne says February 26th, Leo moon. Okay, I'm going to grab my paper so I can take notes. February 26th, Leo moon. So that's a 226 and a Leo moon. I have a Leo moon too, so this is going to be exciting. Watch me cross my eyes when I say how exciting this is going to be. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's a 3-year for you, Anne, and a 3-year with a Leo moon eclipse. This is a very healing phase for Leo moon people. Any Leo moon people out there, it's going to be really powerful for you, because up comes the, I want to sing the song to, what's that song? An up from the ground came a bubbling crude oil, that is. You know, Granny and Grandpa and the Beverly Hillbillies, that's it. Okay, so it's going to be a lot of stuff that bubbles up from your emotional state, but also your very creative state. Leo moon people can have a very creative MO, their modus operandi, is to constantly create something. If not, care for children, make children, teach children. So the Leo moon aspect in a 3-year is all about communication. So if you are writing, wink, wink, it's time to keep writing and keep editing. And if you're not writing, it's time to start and to journal your emotional state, because that's the part that's going to go through the biggest healing. And because I mentioned earlier that Leo is a kind of a fiery, it's a fire sign, but it can be very dramatic. And I just want to remind people that when I was talking earlier about metaphysics, that to trust that you have power and that you are not separate from anything that lives on this earth. All energy is connected, but we don't see it that way, right? And it's sometimes hard to identify with that, but you are pure conscious love, baby. That's what you are. Look at your hand, okay? Your hand, as an example, most folks think that their fingers are separate from the rest of them, but each digit, just imagine that each digit represents an issue in your life. It's connected to your hand, connected to your arm, connected to your entire body, to the whole. And just as you think and act, you know, your mind thinks one thing, your emotions respond differently. It's not separate. You're not separate from your issues. And you are connected at the core to all of your being. And so it's important for you to realize that just as your hand and your fingers are an extension of your whole body, that your problems are connected at the core, at the heart of your matter, which brings me to Leo, whose motto is, I will. And just a couple of definitions to help you understand what's going on with the Leo energy, which is dramatic or melodramatic. And we want to lean toward the drama, not melodrama, and here's why. Leo represents the physical and emotional heart, okay? And your spine and your emotional system. Ego as well, and oh, okay, wait, sidebar. People talk about the ego like it's some evil troll living under your bridge. Your ego is, the job that your ego has is to maintain your biology, to tend to the details of daily living. You're hungry, ego says time to eat. You're tired, ego says time to sleep or rest. Are you angry or happy? Ego says it's time to emote. Now the problem arises that when you forget that you're governed by pure conscious love, and instead you allow the ego to take control. That's when the ego wants to control everything. Because it's motivated by survival. It's not an evil thing. It's got a job. Remember that ego's job is to care for your biology. And a biological creature is founded upon flight or fight, the flight or fight syndrome, immediate gratification, self-preservation, and extremes. We know what all that feels like, right? And it doesn't feel good. If you have fear that there's not enough to go around, or that there's not enough of something, then that's when your ego kicks in and buys all the water in the market because, you know, waiting for the drought or the locusts to come, or runs to the front of the ticket line thinking that before the box office opens, thinking that there's not going to be enough and you won't get the best seats. Your ego is the part of you that has hissy fits and temper tantrums and then acts out to get its needs met. So Leo is all about recognition. And, you know, when you want recognition, that's your ego, but that's not a bad thing. It's not good or bad. When you want to win, that's your ego striving for control. But again, that's not good or bad. You know, sometimes competition motivates us to do better in life. And I want you to look at your ego as the part of you that needs to understand itself so it has perspective, because it's separated from the whole. You know, here's the whole, and then your ego is one little part of the whole, and it's trying to work its way back to being in control. Of course, it can only do and see so much because ego sees, you know, the phrase, think outside the box. Well, egos are the ones who invented the box. There are no boxes. No boxes. No boxes. Pass it on. There's no boxes. And your ego is excellent at managing details and biology. So give it a job. Make it your personal assistant. But remember that you are pure conscious love, and that's what drives the bus. Okay. Oh, hi, Lorraine. June 2nd. Okay, let me just look down at my paper. June, I have to add. So if you give me your month as in the number, that would be so much easier. I start to fragment when there's so much going on the screen and I have to navigate. June is a 6. Okay, you're in a 1 year. Okay, so a 1 year is going to be paramount to knowing what feeds you. And as a Gemini, it's also going to be that June 2nd, not sure what I'm doing at the moment. No, and that's okay, Lorraine, because in the 1 year, you're starting over. And you had a tough year last year. All the things that you didn't want to be doing, you were doing. So you can stop that now. And in this phase of three eclipses, it's important that you look at, go back if you haven't watched the other two live streams on the solar eclipse in Cancer and the lunar eclipse in Aquarius. And people, I'm serious when I say that you have power to, you know, to change and transform. People don't want to change. That's not what they want to do. They want things to be familiar. They want things to be easy. And yeah, why not? But to make it easier for yourself, to write down, and as I said, this is a Leo energy, which can be dramatic. Oh, and here's the difference. Drama is something you've come here to work out on this earth. Melodrama is when you get stuck in a repetitive spiral pattern and you come back to the same thing and back to the same thing. And you're like, didn't we do this? Didn't we have this conversation for 20 years? Didn't I have the same boss 6 times in a row? Am I not done with this yet? So that's what is your job, is to determine, you know, I have to stop right now and think about who I am, what I'm doing, and where I'm going. So as a Gemini, you are dedicated to the details and wanting to move forward, but if you don't know where, and especially with a Mercury in retrograde, Mercury is your muse, your celestial muse, you don't know where you want to go, that's okay, you're going to go in. You're going to figure things out. You're going to look at your responses to situations and then to move forward from that point. But remember, Leo also represents the enoughs in life and fulfillment. So the big wound that Leo, Sun, Rising, or Moon carry, it's either conscious or unconscious. It's the idea that it isn't enough, whatever it is, and whatever that might be. Oh, my daughter and I, Aaliyah, have been making really funny memes. We're posting on Instagram and some of them on Facebook. So here's one. Hang on, if I can get all the clicking right. Okay, when Leo is upset, this is the energy. To the outside world, this is what it looks like. Perturbed, mildly annoyed, and just kind of, what? I'm sorry, what? But deep down, the Leo energy, and this is okay if you don't think you're a Leo sun, rising, or moon, if you don't have that, but you must have Leo somewhere in your chart. Everyone does. Deep down, when Leo is wounded, this is the wounded energy that's projected. But what's really going on the inside is this. And that's the internal mighty jungle roar is happening deep down. It's brewing. And then it's got to come out some way. It's got to come out in some way, shape, or form. So I think it's important that whether you have, you know, a sun, rising, or moon in Leo, that you understand this is a very exciting time for a lot of people, very dramatic, a lot of melodrama in the news today and all week and all month and all year, but it's going to bring things up and to that culmination of, what am I doing? Why am I doing this? And why do I keep circling the same drain? Why do I keep going around the same block over and over and over again? Althea, March 13th. So, hi, Althea. So March is a 3, 6, 7. You're in a 9 year, my dear, with all these eclipses and retrogrades. It's really important that you breathe often, that you go within, that you look at what no longer serves you. The endings come in 7 years and 9 years. And as someone who just came out of a 9 year, just like Lorraine did, the endings are, they carry over into the next year, but this is the year for you, Althea, to really decide how you feel about something before you respond to it. And if you see a repetitive pattern, to look inside first. We are the magnets for everything in our lives. We're the ones who, you know, you have someone in your life, they're there because of you, right? You have a situation or a job or a project you're working on, that's there because of you. So if you don't like what you see in the people around you, in the responses around you, in the lack of responses, okay? Leo needs recognition, so that's what's going to come up right now. You're wanting more recognition. I decided to do these Facebook Lives because I thought, how can I reach a greater audience so I can help you get your mojo back? But at the same time, it wasn't working in writing blogs, and I thought, well, let me just show up. Let me make a connection to my audience. And it's been helping me to feel as if I'm giving more. And my Leo moon really wants recognition. And it wants to know that I'm helping. So every once in a while, I might say, hey, give me a thumbs up, or, you know, create those little heart things that float up like bubbles. Those are cool. And people do that. And then I feel great. And let me help you. How can I help you? So when I look at, we have a 3 year with Anne, a 1 year with Lorraine, and a 9 year with Althea. And oh, Vicky, I'll get to you in just a second. In fact, I have a booked reading with Vicky coming up. So we are really going to get, we're going to get into it. And by the way, folks, if you see the book now button at the top of the screen, that is there for the next 7 days only. And then we go back to the regular pricing of $197 for 30 minutes. Now, Leo also represents entertainment. So the 9 year, the 1 year, the 3 year, it's important for you to come out of this idea that things have to look a certain way, be a certain way. I'm not an artist. I'm not a writer. I don't know how to sing. It doesn't matter. Go somewhere in another town if you have to and do some karaoke and belt it out. Start journaling, take classes and any kind of creative anything that helps to motivate you, and for no other reason than to feel it and then express it. That's what we're looking at right now, to feel it and express it. And the reason why is because this big energy of Leo is very magnanimous and very generous, and sometimes has to, even if a Leo is shy, a Leo person, Leo rising, Leo moon is shy, they still are giving and they still want to be giving, but what's attached to it is the recognition. So it's important that you recognize yourself first, people. This is what's important. Not so much, oh, I need them to acknowledge the fact that I just said something or I apologized. Aren't you going to say, oh, thanks for apologizing? It's like the wounds can build one on top of another. Oops, sorry, with the Leo energy. So what you want to do is how to mitigate all this crap that's going on inside of us is to go to core. And in the core is where you don't recognize yourself. So where might that be? You might be expecting your spouse, your kids, your lover, your friends, your coworkers, you know, everybody else in the world to acknowledge you and your efforts. During this time, you will be acknowledged, because you're going to get back what you've been putting out in the world. That's what eclipses do. But you must go in first and acknowledge yourself. Oh, wow. You know, bake some cookies and eat them and say, these are the best cookies I ever made. But to no one in the room, just to yourself. Start acknowledging yourself. It's going to be great. Let me see. Hang on. Back to the drinks. Okay, folks, if you're just joining us, you can post a comment or a question in the thread below. And if you want me to read you, please give me your birth date in a number, as in May 17th. It could be 517. Without the year, I don't need the year. And if you'd like to go further and go deeper, and with all the readings that I've been doing lately, it's been really amazing that people are so willing. It's like they open up and say, yes, help me. I'm ready. I'm willing. You can click on the book now button for a 30-minute private session with me. And that includes numerology, astrology, clairvoyance, empathy, and everything I am. Karma. I'm going to look at your karmic numbers. I'm going to look at where you keep circling the drain, how you can break past that particular area of confusion or frustration. And Lorraine says, thank you so much. Yes, I have spent a whole year doing exactly what I didn't want. Okay, so now are we done? Okay, and this is great for Geminis to know. Everybody, needs to know this, but especially I tell all my Gemini clients this. When you're doing something, you know what? It's not just for Gemini, but it is for everyone. But I tell my Gemini clients, this seems to work for them. When you're doing something and you are done, you need to admit that you're done. It's not done. I'm done. Okay? Everybody repeat after me. It's not done. I'm done. And one Gemini client said, I have all this paperwork in my office and it's, you know, piling high and high and I have to get to it. And I said, well, take an hour and get to it before or after work. And they said, well, what about on Saturday? I could just go all day. And I said, yeah, you could go all day, but then what about the other stuff that stockpiles that you start to regret because you want to get all this stuff done in your perfectionist mode? In I got to control it all and I have to do it all. So I said, you need to know the moment you are done. I'm done. It's not done. And then come back to it. It's going to be there, right? It's going to be there. So Vicky, we're going to get to yours in the private reading, although you do say that your midheaven is in Leo. So that means big career changes. And we're going to talk about that in your private session. So, okay, eclipses can mess with your sense of time. Now, I said at the onset of this stream that nobody's sleeping in my house. And hope they're sleeping in yours. But the time element, the essence of time, the idea of time exists on this planet only. So sometimes you look at the clock and you think, oh, I thought 3 hours went by. It's only been 15 minutes. What is that? Or you look up and blink. My husband's been coming into my office every day and standing there and just looking at me, taking off his glasses and saying, is it 4 o'clock? I just sat down. It was 9:30. I said, yep, that's the day. Bye-bye day. You know, be happy with it because be present. When you're in the present moment, this is when you can affect a change. Oh, wait, did we not know that? The only moment that you can experience any kind of change is right now. Right now. So when you make a commitment in as many moments as possible, to be as present in as many moments as possible, that's when you are your most powerful. And like Edna says in The Incredibles, no capes. You are powerful. You have a superpower. And I want to see you use that and get your mojo back so that you can start to do what you came to this earth to do. What's your purpose? People ask me that all the time. What's my purpose? What am I doing? Well, a lot of times what I'll see in a chart is the person's part of fortune. And in a part of fortune, that gives the essence of what it sounds like. This is your fortunate event. This is the thing that you're moving toward. This is the thing that you want. And coupled with all the other planets that I read, it's important that you see that you are the one creating the spin around your world. So just like the moon is spinning around the earth, that's spinning around the ecliptic, around the sun and all the other planets, you have power. So what is it that you want to create? What is it that you would like to maybe co-create with someone? You want to make a baby. You want to create a project. You want to write a book. You want to get a job. You want to go overseas. You want to travel. So all these things that are happening in your world are there for a reason. So, and I just, oh, I'm going to interrupt myself and just talk about on Monday, on August 7th at 1 p.m. Pacific. And I actually, where is it? I also do pendulum energy swings. So I did a pendulum. Here's my crystal that I've had for, I don't even know how long, 35 years maybe. And this is my pendulum swing. And I wanted to be really clear about this particular Uranus in Taurus talk that I'm giving on Monday. And so my pendulum said 1 p.m. was the time to do it, my time. 1 p.m. on August 7th, that's 4 p.m. Eastern, Uranus in the sign of Taurus is going to be going into retrograde motion. Now, if you're not into astrology, that's fine. That's totally cool. What that means is your sense of freedom wants a stable road and a practice. And now it's going to go backwards and people are going to freak. And literally, earthquakes happen on the earth when Uranus in an earth sign goes into retrograde motion. So what are we in? I'm looking at my calendar. Okay, we're on the 4th today. So starting today through January 19th, 2019, there can be a lot of earthquakes. There can be a lot of upsets. Now, I'm not saying all of them will be physical, actual earthquakes. They could be your earthquake, your personal, oh my gosh, did the ground shake? I just had an aha. So we want you to have a happy earthquake. We want you to move out of that place, that of resistance, of anger, because Uranus is all about the expression and freedom. So we're going to talk about that on Monday. But it's happening now. You see, all the energy is commingling and happening now. And people say, well, what's going to happen in Mercury retrograde? Well, then there's Mars retrograde, then there's Uranus retrograde, then there's Saturn retrograde. And I'm talking about all of these. I've already spoken about the Mars and the Mercury retrograde. Please go back and listen to my previous lives. While I was working out how to do the videos, I think I got it down. Pretty soon, we're going to do a green screen behind me, and it's going to look like I live in a palatial estate with, you know, flowing curtains and whatever, plants. But right now, you got a blue wall. That's what we're dealing with. My freedom hasn't come yet. Okay. So, now a recap between drama and melodrama. Sometimes people get confused. Drama, as I said earlier, is when Becky's here. Hi from Ohio. Why, Ohio. That's from Glee. That's all I remember. drama is what you've come here to work out. So if you can look at and write down repetitive patterns in your life and look at them on a piece of paper, you will see the same thing happening over and over again, sometimes with different people, of course. But that's okay. So you can become aware of, okay, and it may not be negative. It could be a positive thing or a neutral thing. But the melodrama is what we want to mitigate. The melodrama serves no purpose. It's not even entertaining. How long can you watch Judge Judy? Well, okay, last time I had a pedicure, they had Judge Judy or one of those judge shows up on the thing, and everyone in the row and all the seats were like, oh my gosh, did you hear what she just said? I can't believe what she just did. You know, that's good entertainment for about 20 minutes, but do you want to live with melodrama? No, absolutely not. We're not living with melodrama. There's no purpose to it. But the drama breaks up the patterns that you came to this earth to break up. So let's do that. Now, I want to caution you that if you know that you're a little angry about something and you're not dealing with it because you're busy or because you just don't want to deal with your feelings or your emotions, you might encounter a minor mishap during these eclipses and all of these retrogrades. Now, the mishap could deal with fire, ow, you light a match, you burn your finger, okay, we're done. Or you're cutting your steak and you're not paying attention because you're angry and why is the cat still clawing the curtains? I've done all the spray and it's not working. And then you cut your finger. Okay, great. We don't want it to excel or accelerate into anything bigger, right? So metal, electricity, and fire are the big things happening right now. So get it out of your body in a healthy way. And I'm not saying that the planets do this to us. Oh, no. Oh, Anne says she broke out in a rash 2 nights ago. Okay, so your skin is itching to get out. What needs to come out? Now, you can have an allergic reaction to food. You could have pulled some poison ivy in your backyard. You know, your body's going to go through a chemical thing as well. It may not be emotional, but I find that if we're taking care of ourselves, if we're everything's, you know, looking smooth and clean and scoured on the outside, and we have an incident, I walk through a room and I trip on the carpet, I'm not paying attention. I'm not grounded. I tripped on a shoe once that I didn't even know was in front of me, and I twisted my ankle right before I had to go away. And at that time, I was dealing with so many details. And I just, you know, my body was just saying, sit down, just stop moving. And, you know, I had an ice pack on the airplane. People were like, make way, give her room, take her suitcase, you know, but things will happen if you're not paying attention. I'm sorry that you have a rash. Okay, Anne says no reason. No reason that we know up here, but you're a Leo moon. So I want you to write about what does the rash mean? What is your body saying to you? What is the chatter that's going on? The rash is saying something's itching at you and it's bothering and it's under your skin and something's really wanting to come out. So you want to write about that. And to journal will help you connect the thoughts with the emotion. So planets, okay, folks, planets do not make things happen to you. We live in a cooperation with our cosmos. When the planets make a move, you feel it. When you make a move, the planets reflect that in the cosmos. So there is a cooperation. We live together with all the energies. We are not, you know, super ahead of it, detached from it, and unaffected by it. I'm saying instead that the planets tell us what time it is. I have an astrological watch. It broke. I'm so sad. Okay. Here's my one. My husband gave it to me years ago. Can you see that? Look at that. That's an astrological watch. And I love this thing, but I can't get it to work. But I leave it on my desk anyway, because I always look at it and I go, okay, Elaine, what time is it? Well, it's time to do some business. It's time to do some banking. It's time to blah, blah. So that's what astrology does for us. It tells us what time it is. And then you can stop dragging that dead horse around, okay? The universe will duly notify you. You are the one with the frequency. What you put out, you get back. What you put out, you get back. My husband said, keep your hands above because where we are. If I'm back here, I can't get the microphones. I'm over here and my hands are muted. So I'm doing all this talking with my hands down here. So I'm going to just lift it up. Hey, folks, thanks for joining us. Big heart to you, too. You know, but this Leo eclipse could be amazing for you. What is going to happen? I'm so excited because I'm dealing with my stuff. Even when stuff from the past comes up and I'm frustrated, I said to my husband last night, I'm cranky. And he said, what did I say? What did I do? And I said, not you. And I wanted to get annoyed with him for thinking it was him. And I said, no, sweetie, it's not you. I'm just feeling it. I'm feeling something. And I'm going to need to get quiet, take my amino acids, my PS100, my GABA, and I get as many chewables as I can because they're like, you know, candy to me and they taste good. And L-theanine helps me get to sleep at night. Check with your medical professional. Hi, Lori, your healthcare professional. Check with whomever. I am not a doctor and I don't play one on live streams either. So I have to make that disclaimer. So you want to be able to get into a place that is real for you and be creative about it. Write, sing, dance, paint, emote in some way. Do macrame if it helps you, garden as well. But Leo is a dramatic, you know, like, I'm here. I've just shown up. Isn't life great? And don't you want to tell me that? I saw a commercial once a long time ago. And it's, and please, if you are a Leo and you're listening, this is not, I'm a Leo moon. I'm 6 times more intense than your sun sign. That the commercial was, oh, enough about me. So what do you think about my new dress? So the Leo energy is really looking for something right now. And if you don't think you're getting it, it's up to you to go focus on it, right? Okay. So what we are looking for, and it could be, you know, great news, your family calls, it's great news. Somebody from the past comes back, like I said earlier, someone from my past came back and we just had the greatest chat. You know, we're looking at sudden, possibly radical transformation, and that's coupled with the Uranus in Taurus going retrograde on Monday. So please stay tuned for that Monday at 1 p.m. Now, not everyone is going to have a sudden event. You know, we're not all going to be thrust into a dystopian world and we'll have to save the universe. You know, it may not be that dramatic. Although I know I'll be watching Avatar again and Guardians of the Galaxy and all the Avengers movies this coming week. I know that. Oh, speaking of, today is August 4th. Beginning today-ish, I want you to really look at the week of August 4th through August 15th. This is the most intense time, there we go, for this particular eclipse. This particular eclipse is when you are going to feel it the most. Now, If you also have Leo in your chart, if you're just joining us and you have Leo in your chart, sun, rising, moon, and you could have Pluto in Leo. My husband has Jupiter in Leo and Pluto in Leo. We are hoping that a celebrity to be unnamed so far will want to produce his screenplay. So, you know, something positive and wonderful can happen. And so what I'd like to see you do is to focus on, during this time frame, August 4th through August 15th, especially around the 10th, 11th, and 12th. The eclipse happens exactly on the 11th, but the 10th, 11th, and 12th, you know, let's cram that into an even more intense period. It is your job. I'm knighting every one of you who's on this call. I am now ordaining you. I am blessing you with the power to have the will to put healing into the world. Can you do that? Of course you can. Do you have the right to do that? Yes, you exist. That's your right. So please meditate those 3 days, especially on the 10th, 11th, and 12th, so that you can put love into the world where someone might have ticked you off in the past or is still pissing you off and you don't know what to do with it. We are going to be the adult in the room, ladies. It's us. It's up to us. How many of us are there? I think we could do it. No capes, right? You have your superpower. Mine is reading people. That's my superpower. Yours may be helping children. Yours may be helping someone with, you know what, insurance policies. Okay, you may not think that that's a superpower. Math, to me, is going to be my next superpower. When my mom passed away in December, and I had to start to undergo all the paperwork. And of course, I started doing it again when the certain insurance company that my mom used to work for sent me more paperwork. And I said, okay, I'm about to have a meltdown, because to get through to this company at all, I had to give a social security number of my mother, but she's dead, right? She's passed on. So I kept going in these circles, and I finally got a person and I said, I am asking for your help before I have a personal traumatic meltdown. My mom passed away, and he was, you know, filled with condolences. Thank you so much. But I need someone to walk me through the steps of filling out these forms. Let me transfer you. And while this person was transferring me, instead of going into, you know, crunch mode, I relaxed my body. It's so important. Remember, Leo eclipse is very dramatic. So you want to relax your body. And that's what I did. And I relaxed. And I took a deep breath and I just said repeatedly, my needs are met, my needs are met, my needs are met, even if I don't know how to meet them. And then I got connected with a woman, and Diana, and she stayed on the phone with me for 45 minutes while I filled out all the paperwork, and she answered all my questions. And I thought, okay, this is called a charmed life. 10 years ago, 5 years ago, 3 years ago, when it comes to paperwork, especially insurance paperwork, I lose my cool. And so I thought, well, it's not going to happen again. I am not going to have the melodrama, right? So drama, melodrama, drama, you've come to work it out, melodrama, you repeat the same caca patterns. We don't want to do that. So Star is here, someone I knew from my past. Hi, Star. And the Leo eclipse shines a light on everyone. And relates to, as I said earlier, if you're just joining us, possibly a man in your life, may or may not be visible. Could be someone who affects you, but you don't even know it. Someone in the shadows, in the background, but an energy that propels you forward. Let it be something positive. You will be motivated on your journey by an external force and also the internal need. So we want to couple that with, I need help. Ask for help if you need it. Something wonderful is coming your way. I can feel it. This is the time to meditate, especially if you are a Leo sun, rising, or moon. But for everyone, please do meditate. No matter your sign, the day before, the day of, and the day after an eclipse is the most intense. So avoid overbooking yourself. And remember, you can feel like with all these eclipses and retrograde planets, you can feel like you're caught in a spin or a vortex. So around the same circle, right? We don't want to do that. Fire sign eclipses can feel very electrifying, especially with the Aquarius lunar eclipse that we had on July 27th. We're still in the energy of, and Leo and Aquarius are opposite energies. So when you're empowered in one area, you feel disempowered in the other. So it's up to you to find that balance. And remember, click on the book now button. I'm offering a 30-minute, $97 reading only for one more week. And it's going to be powerful. I will give you everything I am to help you with everything you are. That includes numerology, astrology, clairvoyance, empathy. I'm going to look at your past lives. I'm going to look at what's stopping you now and what are the keys and the actual steps you can take to move forward. And you get a recording of it. Okay. So if you are in a spin and you feel really too intense, what I would like you to do is grab hold of the superpower that you are, your pure conscious love. So I want you to grab hold of that and immediately replace the negatives with like, oh, she never called me back, or, you know, he was supposed to do this thing. Okay, we want to stop that. We want to replace it with, I am enough. Remember, we're in the Leo vibe now, so it's all about enoughs. I am enough. There's enough of everything to go around. That one is for Aquarius, the Aquarius lunar eclipse. There's enough of everything to go around. I am blessed. I am grateful. I am an extension of the light. This is my personal meditation when I began to trance channel over 35 years ago. And I had angelic beings in my living room helping me to wake up. Helping me to wake up. This is the sentence that came out of the back of my head. And I share it with you now. I am an extension of the light. I exist here, now, everywhere. And I'm grateful for that. So fast track your intentions during this eclipse phase. Yes, but what are your intentions? You need to visualize at least once a day, folks, the thing that you want clarity on, the thing that you'd like to manifest. You know, so if there are any last questions, please give me your birth date in number, as in June 22nd. And I don't need the year, and your question. If you have a question, I'm happy to help you. The more specific you are, the more specific I can be for you. So last questions, going once, twice, you take the time to type them in the comment section below. I'm only taking questions during this live broadcast, folks. So if you are listening to the replay, I'm so thankful and grateful that you are listening. You can still book a reading with me, a private session for 30 minutes. Okay, so the actual day of the eclipse is the day to be still, to meditate, to not engage, to be present. Time feels awkward. Weather does weird things. Your perception is off. You may have the most euphoric experience and people are looking at you like, why are you so happy? Did you ever get that? You ever feel really angsty and crappy and, you know, somebody wakes up whistling and, hey, happy day, you know, and you just want to, you know, want to psycho them. So if you get to that point, you're going to stop. You're going to breathe. You're going to meditate. You're going to put love into the world, because I have now ordained you as guardians of the galaxy. Becky says, August 30th, are reactions more intense? Working on reactions a long time. Reactions versus responses. Do you understand the difference? A reaction is, I'm not safe, I'm out of control, you're threatening me, and I'm pissed off. That's a reaction. A reaction is relief, you know, to some degree, not gratitude. A response is, you know, if I were to step on your toe, emotionally, physically, mentally, intellectually, Becky, and I said, blah, blah, or I gave you one of those looks like, oh, you're going to do that? Okay, you know, whatever. Then, and you might suddenly have a reaction like, how dare she do that? Did she just condescend? You know, you're looking for validation and proof from the world. Did she just do that? I'm feeling so, you know, that's a reaction. Because if you're holding the wound, then comments and things are going to poke at it constantly to get you to open up and release that stuff. You can't, you're not a garbage can. Stop carrying that stuff around with you. So to go from a reaction to a response is primo pure conscious love. That's when you take a deep breath. You let it go for the moment and say, I and name the feeling. I feel like laser blasting that person's brain out, or I feel like slapping them across the face. Like in your mind, you can, it's okay to do this. You're in a bubble of healing, so you're not actually doing it. But if you know you're in a bubble of healing and you want to go from a reaction to a response, just name the feeling. I'm so pissed off. And then as you start to come down from the emotional wreckage of the wound, which is high intensity, remember we're in a very electric time, what happens is suddenly you realize, okay, it, you know, maybe I didn't like what they did. I can say so in a very nice way when I'm not feeling so emotional. I can say, you know, Janie, I didn't really appreciate how you spoke to me. Maybe you didn't mean it. Maybe you didn't realize it, but it hurt my feelings. You can do that. Or you can, you know, write furiously in a journal and then I'm going to do this to them. And then, and once you get that out of your body and then you come back to center, and center is pure conscious love. And then you're going to put compassion into the world first for yourself. So look in the mirror, everybody, smile, give love to yourself. I hope that helps. And to go further and deeper, you can click on the, with me, you can click on the book now button. And that's a 30-minute private reading for only $97. And after 7 days, that offer goes away and I'm back to $197 for the 30 minutes. So the regular, that's the regular rate. And I'll be back on Monday, folks. Thank you so much for being here and for joining me and for your questions and for your willingness to transform in this very electric time. As always, I wish you peace, be sparkly, stay present, and I'll see you next time.